I'm a React developer, and I also do mobile application development with React Native. Junior blockchain developer in the US, $220,000. And most of the times, as blockchain developers, we work from home.
So guys, today we are asking software developers what they actually do. Let's get into the video. Can you tell us your name and your role? What do you do?
My name is Meos, and I'm a React developer, and I also do mobile application development with React Native.
Nano says BNG. I'm the developer advocate for ICP Ghana, and I'm also starting a startup company called Prime Use. What we actually do is that we are building an all-in-one music ecosystem, studio streaming, Shazamming or music recognition, everything, creating of sounds and beats onto the internet's computers blockchain. And then we are not yet mainnet, but we'll be going mainnet this year.
I'm Balcrydy. Software developer, especially mobile app.
I'm Kwame Amo. I'm a level 200 student at the University of Ghana, currently pursuing a combined major in computer science and mathematics. So as of now, I'm an aspiring cloud engineer. So basically what we do is, the cloud is sort of a virtual space on the internet where information can be passed to and from between computer networks. So the role of a cloud engineer is basically to manage the infrastructure of these networks and ensure that data can be passed between computers in an efficient way. I'm also pursuing the math so that I can develop more efficient algorithms.
Okay. So for someone who is a beginner, how will you explain blockchain to him?
Okay, decentralized. Yes, not monopolized like the traditional system. So we need to move from a system where there are no single entities who are controlling all our information or data. They exploit us, sell our information to the big tech companies, other big tech companies, and they use it for their personal gain. Meanwhile, we get nothing from it. And their system is also prone to attacks and not that stable. We often hear of, let's say, the server of Twitter, the server of Google down sometimes, but the internet computer, the system is that decentralized, that no single entity controls the whole thing.
Okay, how do you first started as a cloud engineer? How did you?
Yeah, so I've been always interested in the internet as a whole and how networks have actually brought so much advancements, because now everyone, if you're not connected to the internet, it seems you can't do anything. So now with the emergence of cloud computing, I really wanted to go into that space and then discover how I can contribute to the force and then the workforce which are involved in the maintaining and developing of infrastructures which we can use to better understand the cloud.
It started in school, so I came to school, but then it's been a nice and smooth journey, being able to learn a particular language, to be able to use that language to build something out of nothing. Right. I mean, programmers or like software developers are like pathological gods, like create something out of nothing.
So basically, I, before coming to school, didn't really know much about computer science and development. So it was after I got here that I got to realize there are so many opportunities available for developers, right? And so it all started with a course we read in second year, first semester. Multimedia and web design. And so after I was willing to HTML, CSS, JavaScript, React, and a bit of database, MongoDB, backend using Node.js and other stuff. And so afterwards, I decided to take it on and be proficient in it. And so after I learned React, I got to realize there are also a lot of opportunities in mobile application development. And so I had opportunities to learn either Flutter or React Native, which is more like a language that you can develop Android and iOS applications together and customize it if you have to. Yeah. And so after learning that course, I took it upon myself to be very proficient in it.
So what inspired you to be a mobile app developer? Why did you choose that path?
Okay, so I've always wanted to build. I mean, I started with web development and I channeled the energy to mobile app.
Tools and the technologies or frameworks do you use as a cloud engineer?
Yeah, so there are usually three main technologies. You have AWS, which is Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, and then GCP, which is the Google Cloud. The most mainstream of these is the Amazon Web Services. which provides technology such as EC2 and all the infrastructure you need to be able to host applications and other enterprises on the internet. Yeah.
What tools and frameworks or technologies should you focus on to become a blockchain developer or get into Web3?
Okay, so I would be biased here because I'm with the internet computer. So I will tell you that start from the internet computer, and then one of their powerful tool or programming language you can use, which is very simple, just like our traditional Web2 programming language, is called Motoko.
For someone who is interested in the cloud engineer, what skills and frameworks will you recommend?
So I think first of all, you have to master operating systems. So Linux and Windows. Operating systems are the backbone of cloud engineering. Then you must also be able to learn how to develop efficient algorithms to virtually send data over the internet, because everything is about speed and efficiency. So if you can't really develop and deploy your app or software on the cloud as fast as it's supposed to be, people will lose interest, you lose money. So I recommend this YouTube channel. It's called Tech with Suleiman. There are a lot of avenues in the cloud space. So you have cloud solutions architects, you have just cloud architects, you have DevOps, which combines some elements of software engineering with cloud computing, and then you have the cloud engineer, which is sort of a mix between all of these.
I'd advise that you learn and become very proficient in either JavaScript or TypeScript, right? So if you want to start with React and move to React Native, you'd have to learn JavaScript or TypeScript, these two languages, be very proficient in one. And so that's it. You start from there. You'd have to know HTML, CSS, JavaScript, learn a whole lot of CSS, Tailwind, Bootstrap, a whole lot of things about those tools and technologies around CSS, because you're going to need them. And you continue by learning React itself, right? Learn React, be proficient in it, know your front end, know your back end. Your back end, you can decide to use Node.js, which is also a JavaScript language based. Know your ESPO, right? Know your ESPO. Your CLIs, get to know them very, very well. Continue coding, doing projects online, watch a lot of YouTube videos, do your projects, pick courses online, Coursera, Udemy, build projects. That's how you become proficient in what you do.
What's the rewarding part of being a cloud engineer?
Yeah, it's basically means you're flexible. There's versatility everywhere. You can be employed everywhere, because Spotify uses the cloud, Instagram uses the cloud, Facebook uses the cloud, X, which is Twitter, uses the cloud. Most school learning management systems also use the cloud. So once you are a cloud engineer, you have equipped yourselves with the certain skills, you can basically be employed everywhere. So you won't be out of a job, because the internet is constantly and always in use. So I think if you want versatility and you want a job guarantee, I think you should really pursue cloud engineering.
To be a React Native mobile app developer. Yes. You have Android, you have iOS, like Android, iOS. Android is Kotlin, iOS is Swift. But then for React Native, and I would advise someone to be in React Native, because React Native, that one, it's cross platforms. One code base for two platforms, right? Yeah.
Like using Flutter for iOS and Android applications.
React Native kind of guy, so don't go for Flutter.
Is blockchain for the future, or is this a trend?
It's for the future. It's something which is going to take over the internet. We are changing the whole state of the internet. So it's a revolution. It's not like some trend. You can't dissolve blockchain. It's not some trend which is going to pass by and then off, it's gone. No, people, and I mean great people, are actually investing and then pulling their resources. And then we've sat down to think that it's high time we make the whole state of the decentralized, where it can benefit everybody, not just some single entities.
Right. I mean, as of now, every company wants to build a mobile application. ECG has a mobile application right now. MTN has a mobile application. And it's not just about building the project. It's about maintaining and updating the project as time goes on. Right. So every bank as of now is trying to go digital by inculcating mobile applications into their daily activities. So mobile application is very broad, very wide. I mean, I always say that the tech space is very open, right? So wherever you find yourself, there is tech. So if you're a mobile application developer, if you're a React developer, I mean, you can decide to continue with HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, right? But React is a tool in itself that allows you to be very flexible and it helps you, right? It's not complicated. It's easier to do that, to do your web applications in React than other tools. I mean, comparatively, you and I would agree that React is very easy and it helps you. And when you know React, it is easy to transition into other tools or other technologies in web development. When you know React Native, it is easier to transition into using Flutter or any other for Android development or any other thing, right? So basically that.
What's the rewarding part of being a blockchain developer?
It's easy to bag a job and the money is very high. Even checking from the average salary of a junior blockchain developer in the US is $120,000. And most of the times as blockchain developers, we work from home remote. So there are plenty benefits because there are few people in the space as compared to the Web2 space.
Okay, in terms of salary, how much does a cloud engineer make?
Usually it depends because there are a lot of avenues in the cloud space. So a cloud engineer actually makes an average of $230,000 a year. So yeah, it's a very lucrative business. But I don't do it for the money, I do it for the passion. So yeah.
As of now, I don't really get paid for what I do because I develop my projects and put them on GitHub, but I do side gigs, right? So, I mean, in this department, when you know what you're doing, you get a lot of projects to do. Because most of our lecturers are, I mean, they work for big time companies over there. So whenever they get projects, there are times that they give parts of the program or projects they are doing to students to also participate and bring on board ideas. And so when you know what you're doing, you get a lot of opportunities. And so I also do UI UX, right? And so I get a lot of gigs to do. I do UI for companies for application and mobile web and mobile applications. I do UI, I do development for projects. So I don't really have a job or a monthly salary, but I get gigs and I get paid according to what I do. And so it ranges most of the time. It comes. Different gigs come with different salaries, so I can't really point to an amount, but it's good. I mean,
why should someone pursue a career in blockchain development?
Yeah, me from Africa, I will tell you that if you, let's say, as someone who is very interested or very passionate about startups, it's easier to secure funding for your startup if you have a visionary idea and then you see the requirement of the funding agency. It's very easy to get a funding rather than the traditional system where like you go through various unit of steps and then, for example, the Intel computer, we sponsor from $5,000 to $100,000 where we just fund simple and brilliant ideas. We just have to make changes to the central idea, some of our requirements, and then you build whatever you are passionate about. It's a win-win for both of us.
Over the past few years, the internet has really become a key part of everyone's lives, and the ability to be able to share data on the internet and actually all the apps you use in your everyday life, your Google account, everything you store on your phone is made possible by the cloud, because without the cloud you can't really host anything on the internet. So I think in the next few years the cloud is computing and engineering in general will become a very big thing, because more and more people will be looking for ways to save data on the internet and then be able to communicate with each other in a virtual space.
One piece of advice will you give it to someone who wants to get into blockchain? Like,
learn and build stuff and publicize them.
So we've been talking about the best part. What's the challenging part of being?
Okay, I would say that some people would say that there are not much videos on YouTube, but we have ChatGPT, we have AI tools, we have documentation. Ghanaians, we don't like reading documentation. If you read documentation, I think it broadens your horizon about how to understand even the syntax of the language you are using, whether Rust or Solidity or Motoko or TypeScript as well. Kibra.
Okay, what are some of the challenges you face?
The challenge is being able to like adapt to a particular language, and you know this space we it's evolving, right? So So even, let's say, if you are taking React, like every year they release new versions of it and new stuff about it. So you being able to adapt to what's going on in the changing world, right? And there are a lot of frameworks around. If you want to be a developer, there are a lot of frameworks, but you being able to meet the criteria, of course, the world is changing very, very fast. So you being able to catch up so that you don't be behind. Yeah, that's the main.
You want to get hired, so what are you supposed to do? First of all, build your connections. Get your network right. I mean, most of us in this department, a lot of people over here know what they do, but they do not have the connection, they do not have the network to push them out there. There are people who do so much, but no one actually sees them, so you never get hired. There are people who were just average developers, but they had good connections and good networks, and as of now, they are very proficient and very much like a pro, if I can put it that way. And so get your connections right. Continuous learning, right? You continue to learn every single day by building projects and doing real life projects. And these things, you don't just get them by chance. It is through your connections and the people you know, right? That is where you get all these projects and other things that we do. And so by doing it, you become proficient in what you do. You become good, very good at what you do. So get your connections right if you want to get hired in the first place. Two, you also have to know not just the programming language, but the business of computer science. There are people who are developers, but they do not know the business of development, right? And so if you speak to some of our lecturers, they will tell you there are people who are very good in coding and other stuff, but they do not know the business and management and branding of their entire skills. Right? So you should also know how to brand your skill. I mean, when your name is heard somewhere, people should be able to identify you with something. And so I would say get and know your stack. Your stack in the sense that you should be identified by something. This is a broad department: cloud engineering, software engineering, web development, AI, machine learning, cybersecurity. I mean, a whole lot. I can mention about 20 or 30 spaces in the tech space, right? But you should know your stack. You should know that this is a Web3 developer. When we're looking for one anywhere, anytime, any day, you'll be the one to come to mind. This is a React developer. This guy is a UI UX developer. This guy is that. So get your stack, get your connections right, and I'm sure you get a job.
I mean, React Native, the ecosystem for React Native is crazy, right? Yeah, coming out of Facebook. I mean, it's Facebook that built React Native. So the ecosystem is very crazy than Flutter.
Wow. This is really awesome. Let me know in the comment section below, what type of developer are you and what tech career path are you interested in? If you enjoyed this video, then you are going to like the next video. Peace.